So I'm just gonna give a brief summary of the numbers that are presented. We have, in the treasurer's office, we have a current budget adjustment for the current year of a negative 67,000, decrease of 67,000. And majority of that is the original budget had an extra position, one extra position that was budgeted. Believe it was like a treasury liaison type position that was never hired or never put into place. So that needs to be backed out of the current budget so that it's more reflective of the numbers. So that's the main reason for that reduction in the current year budget. And then next year's budget is a small nominal increase of $2,460. So not much change in the budget from this year to next year being presented. And Anna, do you have anything to add or any comments? Any
brief over questions? Aren't there some things that come going? Be cautious and say things.
Okay.
What's the 2,460 increase?
In person services?
Yeah.
That would be for me.
Did you put in?
What was that?
That would be for me.
That was a request for favors.
I have not. I've asked for one since 2015.
Well, we appreciate what you've been doing and holding your own. Are you able to continue to hold your own at this time until things happen down the road? If we had an extended problem, so you feel you're still able to hold your own next year, whatever occurs?
I think so, yeah.
And then you, the new employee, doing pretty good, you know, wrestling?
Yeah, she's great.
Okay. And then the window stays open all the time now, correct?
It does.
Okay, good.
And then the others, besides personal services, the other significant accounts in the department is postage and professional services. Andrew, you want to kind of give a little bit of background? I'm gonna go to those tabs right now. I'm gonna give a little background on the stuff that goes in on those areas. So this is the postage.
The citywide postage, yes, that's for anyone that comes and uses the postage machine in the rec, including the court. And then the summer tax bills, obviously winter tax bills, P.O. Box rentals, the P.O. Box 335, which is for the tax bills. And Federal Express, we don't use that very often, so that one thing that, I mean, it's there if we need it.
Jason, is the position, is the treasurer's salary included into this budget? As part of the budget, correct?
It is correct, yes. Because I have it highlighted right here.
Okay.
And then professional services, I think the line item speaks for itself on the right, but if you want to give a little bit of background with this, Anna or I can.
That is to the legal office that Ed was using to collect the personal property taxes. Thank you.
Send a letter.
Yes.
Do you have any kind of numbers of what they collect, that fee?
Well, any questions? I forgot that one.
We got a report at one time, I want to say, a year or so ago, we were trying to...
Six years ago?
We were trying to compare what we spend versus what we receive, and whether or not we could just keep that in-house, but it's been a while since we got that information.
You got your statements?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can buy it, but...
Thank you.
Okay. And then here's there's the other stuff accounts, miscellaneous items. It's a lot related to can talk about this, and if you'd like, it's related to the envelopes for deposits and things like that, that get accounted for, thrown upstairs for posting, things like that.
I know there was talks at one time, did we ever get new, I mean, I know those are so outdated, maybe we're waiting on the new system, but when are we looking at getting new cash registers and stuff like that? We're still using the old ones, right?
They are, the original.
And through chair, we, like I said, the ERP people are out, they're gonna give an update in the next couple of weeks per council, just probably just, we'll have a letter of council updates and everything, but definitely through the preliminary talks, we're gonna have a brand new, definitely a brand new POS system. It's just choosing which one to go with, but it's gonna be not different than terminals, it's gonna be computer-based and, you know, maybe iPad-based or whatever the case is, but we'll have that discussion with the treasurer's office before that's even decided on, but there'll definitely be a lot of user update for the point of sale system. Because we definitely have an old point of sale system down here, so.
Reminds me of the movie War Games, remember that?
Yeah.
Do you wanna, you gotta look at them. They're 1980 something, I think.
I have to tell you, my nephew today, he's 8, he had one on the S-400, and he looked at the computer and he said, "Are you being hacked?" I thought that'd be great. Yeah. Are you being hacked?
I mean, like, we noticed the training and transportation, that was reduced.
Okay.
That's training for who?
Ed had that in there.
I mean, you know what the training would be for?
It was for him.
He has like some certification, everything.
I believe he attended like one or two conferences a year for treasurer conferences.
Did he receive a benefit package? No. Do you recall he was getting any benefits at all?
Health training?
Yeah, any of that.
I think it was white.
Okay.
I didn't even look at his full-time, I think he just.
I just wanted to.
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Anybody else, Andrew?
Thanks for coming, man, appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thanks, yeah.
Thank you.
All departments were like those two, we'll be out here in about half hour.
No, of course, it's gonna mess it all up.
Here we go.
Come on over, chief.
Okay, you ready for me?
So next up is the fire department, Chief Porter is here, and on your documents, page 36.